The month June is of extreme importance in the history of physics because 14 June 1736, a genius took born in France. Later, he got his degree in engineering. He was posted with the French military in West Indies for 8 years. He came back to home after 8 long years of service, but with a very poor health. He started thinking about the fundamentals of physics. With the help of torsional pendulum, he measured the forces between charges. And 1785 onwards, he started publishing his findings on electricity and magnetism. In his second paper, he gave the world for the first time a mathematical sentence, an equation, which states that the force between two charges is proportional to the product of the two charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them, which is famously known as the Coulomb's law, which lays the foundation stone of electricity and magnetism. An unit of charge is termed as Coulomb in his honor. I'm talking about Charles Augustine Coulomb. 14 June was his birth anniversary. Happy birthday, master.
Electricity and magnetism is all around us. We have electric bulbs, TV, radio, microphones, computers. Transportation is possible because of electricity.
Atoms, molecules exist because of electricity. All the chemical reactions is due to electricity. Our heart cannot beat without electricity. We cannot think without electricity. We cannot see without electricity because light is an electromagnetic wave.
So I decided to conclude this month, June, with some basic things of electricity. Let's begin with simple introduction of a battery. This is a battery or a cell. It has two terminals. This one is positive and this one is negative. This is called a primary battery because this is for one-time use. Whereas this one is rechargeable. Primary batteries, you cannot recharge primary batteries. And if I want to show you the specifications, that is the characteristics of the battery, 9 volt means there is a positive potential between its positive and negative terminal, which is provided by this cell. Alkaline means there is a whole chemistry lab inside this battery where a chemical reaction is going on. I am not going into the details of the reaction. There are two electrodes. This negative one is zinc, which is metal, and this positive one is manganese dioxide. And in between them, there is a solution of potassium hydroxide. Now, potassium hydroxide does not take part into the reaction. The potassium hydroxide remains the same before and after the usage of the battery. In battery, we get electricity or electrical energy at the expense of chemical energy because there is chemical reaction going on. Like all chemistry reactions, chemical reactions, electrons are only taking part in the chemical reaction inside this battery. This is a positive terminal, that does not mean protons are here. This is a negative terminal, this means lots of electrons are here, there is an abundance of electrons here. But positive terminal means there is a shortage of electron here, which together form a positive potential difference between this positive and negative terminal. So if I connect this circuit, what happens is electrons from this negative terminal makes a journey and it take this path. It goes through this lead, this white lead, and then again it take this green path. Again it crosses this white lead, and then it take this red path and then come back to the positive terminal. And there is a convention that as electrons are flowing in this direction, so current is flowing in opposite direction. This is a convention only. If you take that current is also flowing along this direction, there is no harm in it. Physics does not change. this is a series connection because current is taking this path, and the same current which is passing through this number one LED, let's take for the time being that this is number one LED, amount of current passing this LED is the same as the amount of current passing through this LED. Voltage of this 9 volt, this battery can offer at most 9 volt potential difference. So this 9 volt potential difference is shared between the two LEDs according to their wattage. Now I have the third LED. All are connected in series, so same current will pass through. The voltage difference of this 9 volt battery will be shared between the three, among these three LEDs. This is white LED, this is white LED. Specification of these two LEDs are same. They both operate with a forward voltage of 3.3 volt almost. But look at their intensity, this is struggling because of the presence of this 3 watt LED. Now, in place of this white LED, if I put this red LED, this operates with a forward voltage of 1.8 volt. So this is glowing at its fullest because it needs a lower potential to operate than this one. This is what happens when the four LEDs, the same four LEDs are connected in series. Look at their intensity. Now, the same current is going through each LED. Path is also connected. There is no disconnection or any rupture in the connection, nothing like that. This is because this voltage, this battery is not sufficient enough to provide the potential difference which could be shared between these four LEDs. Now we need a 12 volt battery. If I want this LED to function at their fullest.
When we connect four white LEDs, each of forward bias 3.33 volt, no current at all passes through the circuit, because then we need a source of at least 14 volt.
So in series connection, same current is passing through all the elements, but the voltage difference provided by the source is shared by all the components. So when we add any component to the circuit, we need to upgrade our source.
So at our home, if we do series connection, then whenever we add some new appliance, we buy some new gadget, we need to upgrade the source. That is, we need to upgrade the power supply, which is not possible because that is fixed, that is provided by our electric supply, which is 220.
This is a parallel connection. The 9 volt potential difference offered by this battery is the same as the potential difference between these two points. If I take these two points A and B, we have connected two LEDs at A and B parallel to each other, which means when light comes here, it gets two branch to pass. One is this one, other is through this LED. Now, as it has luminosity of 240 lumen and it has luminosity of 60 lumen, which means its intensity is 4 times higher than the intensity of this LED, which means the number of photons emitted from this light is 4 times more than the number of photons emitted from this light. That's why this looks bright. But these two bulbs have the same voltage, but they draw different currents. Now I have connected the LEDs. We have connected actually three LEDs for the time being. This is one, this is two, and this is three. All the three LEDs are connected here, and of course here. And the current from the battery is coming up to here, and it gets this
three branches, and they, I mean, the current through all the three branches, they reunite here, and they make again a return journey to the battery. So when I'm connecting this, all the three leads are glowing with equal intensity, because now each of them are getting the same voltage. And when four diodes are connected in parallel, all the four diodes glow, and they glow with the same intensity because they are experiencing the same potential difference of the battery.
So in parallel connection, each component of the network or circuit draws the same voltage from the source. It draws current according to its wattage or power. That is why we need a parallel connection at our home, not the series connection. Thanks for your time.